Episode number 374. Nevertheless, she still waited patiently till the after dinner. Although she had eaten nothing in the morning, the dinner was brought in at its usual time. Milady then perceived, with terror, that the uniform of the soldiers who guarded her was changed. Then she ventured to ask what had become of Felton. She was told that he had left the castle an hour before on horseback. She inquired if the Baron was still at the castle. The soldier replied that he was, and that he had given orders to be informed if the prisoner wished to speak to him. Milady replied that she was too weak at present, and that her only desire was to be left alone. The soldier went out, leaving the dinner served. Felton was sent away. The marines were removed. Felton was then mistrusted. This was the last blow to the prisoner. Left alone, she arose. The bed, which she had kept from prudence, and that they might believe her seriously wounded, burned like a bed of fire. She cast a glance at the door. The Baron had a plank nailed over the grating. He no doubt feared that by this opening she might still by some diabolical means corrupt her guards. Milady smiled with joy. She was free now to give way to her transports without being observed. She traversed the chamber with the excitement of a furious maniac, or of a tigress shut up in an iron cage. Certes, if the knife had been left in her power, she would now have thought, not of killing herself, but of killing the Baron. At 6 o'clock Lord de Winter came in. He was armed at all points. This man, in whom Milady till that time had only seen a very simple gentleman, had become an admirable jailer. He appeared to foresee all, to divine all, to anticipate all. A single look at Milady apprised him of all that was passing in her mind. "Aye," said he, "I see, but you shall not kill me today. You have no longer a weapon, and besides, I am on my guard. You had begun to pervert my poor Felton. He was yielding to your infernal influence, but I will save him. He will never see you again. All is over. Get your clothes together. Tomorrow you will go. I had fixed the embarkation for the 24th, but I have reflected that the more promptly the affair takes place the more sure it will be. Tomorrow, by 12 o'clock, I shall have the order for your exile, signed, Buckingham. If you speak a single word to anyone before going aboard ship, my sergeant will blow your brains out. He has orders to do so. If when on the ship you speak a single word to anyone before the captain permits you, the captain will have you thrown into the sea. That is agreed upon. Au revoir, then, that is all I have to say today. Tomorrow I will see you again, to take my leave." With these words the Baron went out. Milady had listened to all this menacing tirade with a smile of disdain on her lips, but rage in her heart. Supper was served. Milady felt that she stood in need of all her strength. She did not know what might take place during this night, which approached so menacingly, for large masses of cloud rolled over the face of the sky, and distant lightning announced a storm.